Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have discussed the concept of uniform and non-uniform motion. Now, on the basis of non-uniform motion, we have also discussed average velocity and instantaneous velocity. Now, today, we will study graphical discussion of average velocity. How can we find average velocity graphically? As average velocity of an object is equal to ratio of change in position to the time taken. So let me take for non-uniform motion. This is specially for non-uniform motion. You can say that the concept of average velocity exists only for the non-uniform motion. So when we are plotting position time graph for non-uniform motion, graph will not be a straight line. It will be a curve. Now, as velocity at different instant of time will be different. Suppose we are taking at this point, if we will draw the tangent here, the speed will be. I will just explain it like here. A rough explanation I am taking here. Like we are taking point A here. If I will draw a tangent at this point, this tangent will meet somewhere on the axis. If I am taking any point B here, then tangent at this point, this is making angle this one. So you see, as we are taking the different points, we are taking different points on the curve and the increasing of the time, we are finding that this angle is goes on increasing. When angle is increasing and slope of the graph at this any point, it will be given by tangent of theta. So tangent theta, that means if angle is increasing, this tangent function will also increase and hence slope increase. It means velocity at different instant A, B and this point can be C, it is not C. So, if the graph is a curve, then velocity will be different at different instant of time. We cannot find uniform speed. So, that's why we can find average velocity from here. So, here you can see from the graph, we have taken separate point, but we are getting only different velocities. Velocity will not be same. So, using this concept here, while explaining the graphical representation for non-uniform motion, that we are considering two points A and B on this curve. Now, join these two points with the help of any chord, any line. Let me produce this line meeting the time axis. Let it be at an angle theta. So now, corresponding to point A, let position is represented by x1 and time is t1. Similarly, for point B, its position on axis is depicted by x2 and time is t2. So, let we take this point A and B and join this by a line that is making an angle theta with the axis. So, A and B positions and time we have located. Now, what we have to do in the next step, that what we will do here, as here initial position is A, final position is B, we have to find change in position. Change in position we have to obtain, that is, it will be equal to final position x2 minus x1. So it will be x2 minus x1. Corresponding change in time. Corresponding to position A and B, their timings are t1 and t2. So change in time will be final time minus initial time. Now, Let me join this line on this B. You can take it as A, B, C, D. Let this point be P. So, join AP on line BC. So, this angle will also be theta. You can see here. This angle is theta. Now, from here, slope of a line joining two points AB, this will be equal to tangent theta. Here we are calculating the slope of this. Now we have to calculate tangent theta. Tangent theta, so in this triangle ATB, tangent theta will be perpendicular upon base. So it will be equal to perpendicular upon base. What is perpendicular? This is BP upon AP. Now see here in the figure, this BP, you can take it as this BP equal to, see in the figure, BP is equal to CB minus CP. BP is equal to CB minus CP. So on this basis, this CB is equal to x2 and your CP is equal to x1. So what it will be? It will be x2 minus x1. So I will write it out here, x2 minus x1. Similarly, AP. AP will be equal to CD. Now see in the figure again, AP will be equal to CD. Now see here, AP is equal to CD. Now CD will be equal to OC minus OD. So from here, this is you are taking OC minus OD. Now you can see this OC is T2 and OD is T1. So now you can write it as AP is equal to CD, that is equal to T2 minus T1. So this AP is base and BP is perpendicular. So tangent theta, this will be equal to x2 minus x1 upon T2 minus T1. This can be represented by del x by del t, change in position to the change in time. So what do you conclude? That average velocity, it is equal to slope of straight line joining any two points on the graph. Slope of line joining any two points on the graph, it will give you the concept of average velocity. See, although the concept is quite similar, here as per this particular graph, what we are trying to explain here, that if you have been asked, explain average velocity graphically for non-uniform motion. Explain average velocity graphically for non-uniform motion. So, first of all, you will draw the graph. You will take two points, corresponding positions and time you will note. Then you have to find slope of this graph. From the slope of the graph, you will get this tangent theta. This is equal to average velocity. So, what is the conclusion? You have to learn it. Average velocity is equal to slope of line joining two points on the graph. Now, after average velocity, next we will study instantaneous velocity for non-uniform motion by graphical method. See, again, this concept we are taking, so we have to draw the graph again for non-uniform motion. This position time graph we are drawing, and let the curve is like this. As we have explained just before this point, that we have taken different points, the velocity will be different because angle subtended by the tangent will be different. So basically, this instantaneous velocity, it help you to explain that how fast an object is moving at different instant of time. And you know, the basic formula for instantaneous velocity is, this is taken as limiting case of average velocity. This is the basic formula. Here we are explaining this particular concept. From this graph we will explain this. Now when you have to explain this, what point you have to just take care? You will consider two points. See, if you are taking two points at far distance apart, the separation distance is del x. If I am taking the two points closer, now as compared to these two points, these two points are very closer. Again, if I am taking two points so close that they are appearing to be one. That means when the two points are lying very close to each other, so the difference of time is negligibly small. This is almost zero. So the point will be treated as a single point. This concept we will use here. Although this concept we are taking, we will explain here that we will consider two points so close to each other so that del t tending to zero. That means difference of time is approximately zero. So, but when you will explain, if I will take two points so close on this curve, then you will be not able to understand the point. Actually, here we will take two points. Let I am taking A point here, B point here. We have to take two points A and B close to each other. We have to take two points so close to each other so that when you will join this by a line, this will be a tangent. See, this is a hypothetical point I am taking. Actually, these are separated points. But for giving you clarity of figure, I am taking them separate. But in general way, these are lying very close to each other. If I will take very close, suppose I will take one point very close, so how I will differentiate between their positions, their position difference, their corresponding time. So that's why I'm taking these two points. So consider two points A and B, and the corresponding position on the axis are, position is x1, time is t1. For point B, its position is x2, time is t2. Again, we are just producing it, meeting at point C, let it be D, it be E. So now, if this angle is theta, this angle will also be theta. See, we have done the same concept as we were explaining earlier. Here we have taken the points closer, so we have to focus on this point. Again, from this you can explain, you can just see in the figure only, this BC will be equal to B. D minus CD, this will be equal to X2 minus X1. This BC will be X2 minus X1. Similarly, this AC will be equal to ED, and this is, you can take it as, this ED will be equal to OB minus OE. So it will be T2 minus T1. All this concept we have done in the previous case also. So now, what we are doing here, basically we will find tangent theta, slope of this tangent drawn. This will be again BC upon EC, so it will be X2 minus X1 upon T2 minus T1. This can be simplified as del X upon del T. So, but one condition is there, the points we are taking, these are close to each other. When the points are so close, so that del T tending to 0, this is an essential condition, which will convert this average velocity, this is average velocity, into instantaneous velocity. Now, limit is taken for average velocity. So here you will take it as, this instantaneous velocity will be taken as limiting case of average velocity when del t tending to 0. That means as per the basic concept, average velocity del L upon del T. So this will be taken as this instantaneous velocity. And now we know this can be represented by dx upon dt. So what we conclude, all the steps are identical. You can see here all the steps are identical. But what is a change? There is a change. When this kind of question can be asked, it can be asked, explain the concept of instantaneous velocity for non-uniform motion by graphical method. So what is the conclusion? That instantaneous velocity is equal to slope of position time graph at a particular instant. Or in a simple way, you can take it as slope of tangent to position time graph at a particular instant. See, when we are taking at a one particular instant, that one particular instant, then that line will become as a tangent. So slope of tangent to position time graph, this is giving you instantaneous velocity. So this is the basic concept we have explained. Sometimes within 2 marks this derivation can be asked, so you have to practice it also. Now, after this, next we are taking a very important topic, that is relative velocity. Relative velocity, the term indicates relative, that means it is measured with respect to something. See, when we are taking that a car is moving, that means this measurement is done with respect to ground. When we are taking that a person is stationary, how can you say this is stationary or this is moving? This can be just with respect to ground, with respect to earth. So for all our motion, we treat our measurement of position, speed, velocity, we will take some reference point. That reference point for our purpose is ground only, earth only. Now, as we have to explain the concept of relative velocity, in that particular case, first of all, I will tell you, suppose you are going in a bus or any vehicle and side by trees, you can just observe. When you are passing, this bus is moving, you are sitting. And just what you will observe, what first thought come in your mind, that when the bus or the car is moving, these trees are moving backward. Usually, such kind of illusions can be there that when a vehicle is moving forward, the object which is stationary, obviously that will appear to us moving in the backward direction. But actually what is happening? That the object, tree, building are at their stationary position, but here the vehicle is moving forward. So this concept of relative velocity helps us to analyze such kind of situation in different manner. So when we take relative velocity, it is defined as the time rate of change of relative position. Time rate of change of relative position of one object with respect to other. That means, suppose you are saying change in position of one object with respect to other. Here we are saying time rate, that means this is varying with the time. Then position divided by time, this will be taken as the velocity. So VA minus VB. So what we are taking here, time rate of change of relative position of an object with respect to other. Symbolically, we can represent it as VAB. So it means if definition has been asked, then you can write this one. This is defined as time rate of change of position of an object with respect to another object. Now, as we have to understand it, so first of all, as I have just explained, this is the representation. When we have to measure speed of one object with respect to another object, then what we will write? Suppose here we are finding speed or velocity of object A with respect to B. We will measure it as VA minus VB, provided both are moving in parallel direction, along the same direction. This is a condition. When both are moving in the same direction, the formula we will take it as VA minus VB, as this is velocity of A, this is velocity of B. So now, but if we will take it as VBA, that means velocity of B with respect to A. This will be VB minus VA. How can we understand it? Suppose we are taking the same motion, both are moving along this direction, but now we have to study velocity of B with respect to A. So here it will be taken as magnitude of B minus VA. That means here VB will be the main velocity and VA is the reference with respect to which we are observing it. This concept we have studied, this seems to be very theoretical. Let me take some practical examples to it. If we are taking that ground, your earth, this is always taken to be at rest, so its velocity is zero. Suppose a car is moving with a speed of 50 km per hour. So actually, at every time we are measuring velocity of car with respect to ground. As car having speed 50 and ground having speed 0, so relative velocity of car with respect to ground is 50 km per hour. So this can be taken as absolute velocity. Actually, there is no concept of absolute because measurement is always done with respect to some reference point or with respect to some horizon. That means earth is taken as an origin, ground is taken as a reference point. So here velocity of car is taken to be 50 km per hour. Now, if it has been asked velocity of ground with respect to car, see, just suppose it, as per the formula, Vc, Vg minus Vc. Now, we have to understand what is the difference, what is the significance difference between these two. Ground is at rest, see, velocity of car is 50 km per hour. Now, velocity of ground with respect to car is minus 50 km per hour. Actually, what does this signify is that car is moving ahead of ground with a speed of 50 km per hour. But from the second step, what is clear that here ground is or earth is lagging behind with a speed of 50 km per hour. Actually, this ground is at rest. Car is moving. But when we have to measure the velocity or the speed of ground with respect to car, then it is appearing to move in the opposite direction. I have given the example that this vehicle is moving and the passerby, whether this train or the car or the bus is moving, then surrounding on this, if the tree is there, then they will appear to move in the backward direction. Actually, this is giving that this ground or a tree is lagging behind this vehicle with this particular speed. Only this much is the significance. This negative sign only indicates that the ground is lagging behind with the speed of 50 km per hour. In what case? When we are measuring velocity of ground with respect to car. But if we are measuring velocity of car with respect to ground, then it means car is moving ahead of ground with a speed of 50 km per hour. Students, because this concept is very important to understand. If you are able to understand this, then we can proceed further. When we have to measure velocity of one object with respect to other, when both are moving in the same direction, first condition I am taking, when both are moving in the same direction, but since ground is at rest, so it will not influence. So in that case, if velocity of moving object you have to calculate with respect to ground, it will be positive. It means the object is moving forward. But if you have to find velocity of ground or tree with respect to moving object, then it will come out to be negative. It means car is moving ahead, but the object is lagging behind with the same speed. Now let me take here, initially we have taken velocity of car with respect to ground. Let me take the two bodies, two cars, you can say that A is moving with the speed of 30 km per hour and B is moving with the speed of 50 km per hour. If we have to calculate relative velocity of B with respect to A, first suffix indicate velocity of the object you have to find, second indicate with respect to other. So it will be VB minus VA. So it is 50 minus 30. That means 20 km per hour. Velocity of B with respect to A is 20 km per hour. It means this B is moving ahead with 20 km per hour. What is the meaning? Actually, you can see that this 30 km per hour, this speed is the common one among these two. Which is the extra part here? This is 20 km per hour. Due to this extra part, this B car is moving ahead. If this will be equal, there will be no concept of difference between the velocity. So here, if velocity of B is to be calculated with respect to A, then it is coming out to be 20 km per hour. It means B is moving ahead than that of A with 20 km per hour. But if you have to calculate velocity of A with respect to B, again these are moving in the same direction. I have not taken in opposite direction, just taking in the same direction. So VAB will be VA minus VB. So now VA is less 30, whatever be the magnitude you will substitute. 30 minus 50 minus 20 km per hour. See here the negative sign. What does it indicate? Now A and B both are moving, but because B has more speed, so that's why A is lagging behind. With what amount? With a speed of 20 km per hour. So it means their negative sign indicate that velocity of, you can say that A is lagging behind B with 20 km per hour. Now let me take one case. Suppose you along with your friend, these are moving. Suppose you are going on a cycle, you are moving on parallel. So actually with respect to ground, suppose this is one person, this is second person moving with velocity V1, V2. If both are moving with a speed of 5 km per hour, you are cycling. Suppose, so in that particular case, what will happen? Actually, as per the basic statement of relative velocity, rate of change of position of an object with respect to other. If both are moving with the same speed, so when they will move after a certain time, they will be at the same position. Their position will not change. So in that particular case, velocity of one with respect to two will be 5 minus 5, this will be 0. Or velocity of 2 with respect to 1, this will again be 5 minus 5 equal to 0. It means we know with respect to ground, with respect to earth, both are changing their position. But with respect to each other, there is no change in its position. So such kind of concepts will be coming. You can say that as the bus is moving and the passengers, all the passengers are at their same position with each other. So they are not in motion. You are treating them as to be at rest position. We have studied this basic concept when introducing this chapter in the same manner. But when we are taking the motion of two bodies which are moving with the same speed, their position will not change. So with respect to each other, they will not change their position. So in this way, we will introduce few numerical. This concept is important for the basic concept from derivation point of view, graphs as well as conceptual and numerical. So I have just introduced the concept of relative velocity, what is the significance of it. Now, I will take if the bodies are moving in opposite direction. Opposite direction, that means A is moving along here and B is moving along here, whatever be the magnitude of A and B. Now see what happened in that particular case. As A is moving along here, B is along here, if we have to find VAB, velocity of A with respect to B, what is the standard formula? VA minus VB. But this formula is applicable when both are in the same direction. So here, if we will change its direction, just a hypothetical point to make both direction to be same. If direction is reversed, if this direction is taken positive, so this direction will be negative for B. So this will be minus VB. This is an important point which we have to understand. See here, B is moving along this direction. Suppose this is moving along right side and this is moving along left side. But this formula we have applied when both are moving in the same direction. So to make direction of both the bodies to be similar, we will take opposite direction of P. So along this direction, it will be negative of P. Now, here you will take VA minus minus VB. Why we have taken minus? Because along this right direction, both having same direction, but this direction is represented by negative sign. So this will be VA plus VB. Similarly, I will explain it for VBA. Suppose we have to find velocity of B with respect to A, so it will be VB minus VA. See here, as in the same case, VA here, VB here. But now we have to find velocity of B with respect to A. So whose direction has to be changed? A. With respect to A. So that means what should be the direction of A? That should be same as that of B. So along direction of B, the direction of A, that will be parallel. So here in this direction, it will be minus VA. It will be minus VA. So now here you apply VB minus as per the point we have discussed. So VB and minus VA in the same direction. So it will be VB plus VA. So basically when the bodies are moving in opposite direction, in that particular case, either you have to find velocity of A with respect to B or velocity of B with respect to A, directly you will take, it will be equal to sum of magnitude of their velocities. But when the bodies are moving in the same direction, then velocity of A with respect to another is taken as difference in magnitude of two velocities. Actually, wherever you will apply the formula, you will always remember this formula. This should be the standard formula. Don't take this to be positive sum of these two, because direction you will always use for it when we are taking the concept of velocity. So here standard formula will be this one, and you have to apply the direction when the bodies are taking in the opposite direction. So this will be the result for it. Now, after understanding the concept of relative velocity, now as per the definition, we will obtain its expression. So for it, what we are taking, consider two bodies A and B moving with uniform velocities V1 and V2. V1 and V2, we are taking its velocity. See here, in this part, actually we have not introduced the concept of vector. So sometimes if I will write it before without vector sign, this V1 and V2, this will be valid for this because we have not introduced vector. But if you are placing the vector sign over it, that's also okay. So now, two bodies A and B are moving with uniform velocity V1 and V2 along two parallel tracks. Along these two parallel tracks, they are moving. Now, let x01 and x02. This is representing initial displacement of body A. That means at t equal to 0. It means here time horizon is there. Now, maybe the body has covered some initial displacement here. Some distance it has been traveling. Suppose you are taking that you are moving in a train, and at this point you just notice that I have to record the time, whatever time it will take. So here you will start noting your watch in the wristwatch. Suppose it is 9 a.m. that will be taken as the horizon, and after that you will note down the time after which you will complete your journey. But it doesn't mean that your motion has not been started before that. Your motion is actually covered. So that initial motion is measured as distance, that or displacement as initial displacement. So x01 is the initial displacement of A at t equal to 0. Similarly, x02 is initial displacement of B at the same time, at before the horizon, whatever be the time it, distance it has been covered. Now let we take after time t, x1 and x2 be the displacement of the two bodies. X1 is for A and X2 is for B. So now what will be X1? See here, X1 is the total distance covered by body A moving with velocity V1. Suppose it is moving with velocity V1. It has covered distance X01 before. So X01 plus distance covered with this velocity V1 for time t. So what it will be? This will be X01 plus with V1 velocity for time t, what is the distance covered? That will be given by V into t. Similarly, for body B, this final position, or you can say the x2, that is the displacement after time t, it will be x02, initial displacement, plus body moving with velocity v2 for time t. So these are the two equations. I have already taken this concept while explaining the concept of uniform motion, so you can understand it. Now, what should be the next step? That you have to subtract equation 2 and 1. So, x2 minus x1 will be x02 minus x01 plus v2 minus v1 into t. So, now here you can represent this x2 minus x1 by x, where x can be taken as x2 minus x1, and this x02 minus x01, that is the displacement, initial displacement, so it is represented by x0. So x equal to x0 plus v2 minus v1 into t, where x is this one, x2 minus x1, and x0 initial displacement, that is x02 minus x01, that means relative displacement of second body with respect to first, that is position or displacement of second body after time t with respect to first. So now, from this expression, what we are concluding, that if we have to find v2 minus v1, then you can take, rearrange. So v2 minus v1 will be x minus x0 upon t. So you can see, as per the statement of relative velocity, it is defined as time, rate of change of position of one object with respect to another. So this way we have introduced the concept of relative velocity. It's very important. First of all, understand it with the example. Still, if you have any doubt, just pause the video again, watch it. And then finally, after that, you have to obtain the expression for relative velocity. So step by step, it is quite simple. Here, what we have taken the displacement after time t in terms of initial displacement as well as moving with velocities v1 and v2. Then subtracting the equations, we have obtained relative velocity of second body with respect to 1B given by this one. So that's all for today. Here we have discussed all these points. Understand these concepts very carefully, because if it will be clear, in the next video I will cover the graphical representation of this relative velocity and the numerical concept. That is quite very, very important. So understand it carefully. Thank you. Have a nice day.